Alrighty, so how is our ore area going? Okay. I thought that was the ore area for a second there, and I was like, what's happened to my game? But no, it's over here. Hello, Bob Dendry here, and welcome back to the channel. Today, we are playing City Skylines as episode 4 of our Lorikeet Valley build. So, welcome to the show. Hope you enjoyed the Battlefield video from yesterday. I don't know what was going wrong with it, I just couldn't get the game to play. But we're back in nice, comfortable City Skylines today, so hopefully we won't have any problems with this game. Now, I've been thinking about what we can build this episode, because we still need to get quite a bit of population down so that we can unlock like railways and stuff like that, which I want to work with. But if I look at our resource overlay, we've got some ore here that we can use. We've also got some forestry as well, but I'm thinking we might put down an ore area here. So we'll have to cross the highway, obviously. I did also turn down the, I turned it off, the dummy traffic. And it does seem that the traffic is actually a lot better now that I've turned that off and I've restarted the game, which is good. I'm not sure if there's another mod that will allow you to, I've said it's all looking good, but it's still looking pretty busy here. Very busy indeed. That's all right. We'll make it work. Okay. Alrighty, so we're gonna try and keep this fairly natural looking, but obviously we are gonna have to do some excavation. We are gonna need to do some terraforming to make it a usable pit mine. But hopefully it's not gonna be too bad. Now, in terms of getting over there, I'm thinking we'll just put in another T intersection like here or something like that. We don't want to turn this into a four-way at either of these. I think that's just going to be too much trouble than it's worth. But just putting another T here shouldn't be too bad, hopefully. So let's get started on that. We're just gonna go up the side of this hill in a fairly easy way. Obviously, we're gonna have trucks using this road, so we don't want it to be too difficult for them to get up the hill. And how does that look? Yeah, that's not too bad. And we're just going to stick with just a country road at the moment. I think that isn't too bad. Should be fairly useful to start with. And yeah, I think it's time for us to start doing some terraforming. So if I bring up the natural resources, so we've got a fairly large area that we can use here. And we've even got a little bit on the other side of our city limits at the moment that we could use in the future if we wanted to. But we're gonna just keep it nice and simple for the moment. And what we're gonna do is we probably wanna go this contour or this level here. And we'll just need to start just expanding. It looks like it might even like, from an Australian point of view, this looks like an old like riverbed that's dried up as well. It's got that sort of sandy, sandy ground. And where else do we have? just extend this a little bit further. Nice, and I can tell you the community of Lorikeet Valley may not be too happy about us building a big open pit mine. It is a bit of a hot button issue in Australia at the moment, especially looking at like large multinational companies coming in and trying to build large mines. We'll just move our rocks over there. But of course, I mean, I'm all for transitioning away from coal and sort of fossil fuels, but you have to also admit that they provide a lot of employment for, you know, country towns, especially country towns that have pretty much just been thrown up because of the mines themselves. So it's actually tough. It is. I think it's a tough for these communities to, you know, transition away from coal while still maintaining jobs. Like if I look at where I grew up in Newcastle, there was a BHP steelworks in the area, which closed down, I want to say late 80s, early 90s, and it did a lot of damage to the community, and it required a lot of work to, you know, bring the city back from that. And you also had the Newcastle earthquake in 1989, which did a lot of damage to the city as well. So these sort of structural changes, especially when you add in, you know, the sort of upheaval from a natural disaster, it really hurts a city. And I think there's still people, you know, in Newcastle that probably still haven't really recovered from those two events. Okay, and this is, I think this is pretty good. That's going to be quite great, but we can do some finagling if we need to. But I think that's pretty good. It's coming down the side of the pit, and from there we can pretty much just head down to the bottom. if we quickly fix that up, because that looks a bit silly. Okay. Nice. I just want to check my time settings, because it seems very dark. Oh, I have the night cycle on still. That makes sense. I was like, wow, why is it so dark? Okay, so I think that's pretty good. We need to now lay a bit of road down for us to put our, you know, actual industrial bits and pieces on, or our manufacturing, primary industry, whatever you want to call it. and maybe do just a bit of a loop around here. And we'll see if we can get this road back up to there. Perfect. All right, that doesn't look too bad. I think probably a little bit of smoothing is needed for some of these side roads, but as a whole, it's pretty decent. Now let's lay down our industry area and get our main building in. And the actual main building doesn't really need to be in the in the pit, because it doesn't, you know, actually produce anything. So we might just extend this out a bit, and we can have some sort of offices up the top and save the actual ore area for production buildings. Alrighty. So it's the garnet ore area. We'll leave it for the moment. And we can perhaps come up with a better name down the track. Ooh. I've just noticed we've got high residential demand once again, but we'll lay down a bit of industry first. And then while we're waiting for that to level up, we can lay down some more residential as well. So these are reasonably small, so this is all we really have in terms of the base production at the moment right now is the small ore mines. So we might lay down maybe three of those to start with, and we can also loop it around to the other side as well, should we need to do that. And then we've got our ore grinding mill, which will convert our raw materials into metal. Once again, this doesn't need to be in the pit area, so we might maybe build a small sort of industrial grid up here that we can use for our like secondary, or you know, our conversion process. So I'll just expand this just a little bit more. And we'll see what we can do in terms of laying out a little grid here. Obviously we've got some decent topography to be wrestling with here, but I think it shouldn't be too bad. This green road, I think it's called, green drive, will function as a bit of a collector. So we don't want to be putting our production buildings directly onto this road, but we can put some sort of directly off the side roads like this. And so we've got a few there that we can, you know, start feeding some ore to. And we've also got a few storage buildings as well that we can use, I think. Yeah, so we've got sand storage. Oh no. Have I crashed? Oh, we're back. Okay, that was weird. Wow, that lagged for like 20 seconds. And I thought I'd definitely crashed there, but I selected to wait for the program to respond, and it came back. Luckily. Okay, so we've got a couple of little storage areas here. And we probably want to get some generic industry storage up here for our production from these buildings. I'm so eloquent right now. Okay, it's like too steep. We can get another production. Whoops. Another production building in there anyway. And that, wow, that is definitely a slope too steep. I have this bad habit of being at a very sort of orthogonal angle, so I can't really see the perspective. So we might have to fix that up, but it's okay to start with. And we will get down just a couple of warehouse yards. And we'll set those to store metals. You'd probably expect the metal to be outside, at least I would anyway. Oh, wows. Okay. That's alright, we'll come back. Now we will need some water. So we'll just feed some water over to our industrial area. Of course, following the roads, as we do with our water pipes. Alrighty, so we're all hooked up for water now. We've got plenty of water availability, so that is fine. Other thing we will need is to hook up some power to our industry area. So I'll set up some large transmission lines, just easiest for it to come over from this bit of the city at this point. So that is fine. And then we'll need to just connect up the different areas that require power. Alright, perfect. So we've got power and water for our ore area at the moment. So we will just let that sit for the moment and start to do some work. And we'll see here, we actually have some people starting to come in now. So we've got some of our employees, and we've also got some industrial or some industry trucks bringing some goods in. Okay, so we have lots of housing demand, and where should we build our next little suburb? We could potentially build some housing on this side of our highway. That would be, might be people who work in the mines, might be some housing provided by the mining company, or we could continue expanding sort of this part of our city. And I'm thinking we'll probably continue building up our Belmont district here. Just finish that off. And then we can perhaps maybe put in a new sort of suburb in here as well that would also be a newer development compared to what we were looking at with Belmont. So once again, we're looking at 12 by 12 grids. And we don't need that power line there. We can just... Actually, we don't need one at all. Everything connects up now, so... We'll pull that down. I just want to make sure... Yeah, we'll just expand Belmont a little bit more. And... Yep, perfect. Okay, we've got a bit more grid for Belmont here, and we will also join up to our farming area as well. All right, and we'll use a tiny bit of light commercial just up against the farming area itself. In fact, I don't like that. Let's not do that because we've got our nice little trees here. Okay. Alrighty, so let's just lay down all of this as residential. Obviously, we've got so much demand right now that this is probably going to fill up quite quickly, I would expect. And we'll just trim the district a little bit. Oop, no, we didn't want to trim that much. Okay, perfect. So that should get us a little bit more population in. And we'll just go check on our ore area and see how that is looking as well. So got a bit of ore being extracted. And we've got a little bit of metals being produced, which is good as well. Oh, and you'll notice we've got a massive traffic jam here. So this second connection we've built past our nature reserve is actually causing a lot of backup. So let's have a look at our traffic numbers and see what they're looking like right now. So it's 80, so it's still doing all right, but definitely looks like there's some optimization we could be potentially doing here. Maybe a roundabout might be good. And we're not going to be encroaching on too much of the nature reserve if we go to do that. But we'll need to acquire some properties. So I think we might do that. This will just be a nice quick traffic fix we can make. It's not going to be too big a roundabout, but it'll just help to sort of ease that flow of traffic through. Want some nice straight roads. As I said, this is a nice small roundabout. It's only going to be like 10 wide roundabout. And we'll just use move it to make sure all of our nodes are all level and in the same place. Set it to the middle. Perfect. So that is nice and square, or it's a nice cross. They're all at right angles to each other. And we will need probably just two lanes at the moment. We might turn off some of our guides as well. So we'll just go for road length and angle as well, sorry. And grid. Hang on. No, sorry, we want road length and angle. Okay. Okay. Alright, they've all gone down as bridge pieces, so we'll have to fix that. But that's fine. Perfect. Let's take that back a little bit. We'll take Green Street back a little bit as well, just so I can curve around at, for a nice sort of right angle. Okay. Ooh, that's that's nasty. Okay, and that should be fairly nice. We'll just quickly have a fiddle with some of the angles, or the slopes, I should say. But other than that, this should serve us quite well, I think. Okay. We'll just need to do a little bit of adjusting of our terrain as well. Do a bit of smoothing. It's smooth enough. What we might need to do, we're going to place our path back, but we're going to change it to a park path, and the reason for that is these will the terrain will actually conform to the path. Could be better, but it's not too bad. And finally, just need to fix up our fence. Whoa, hang on. Was it this curved before? I feel like it wasn't, hey. Okay. Fixed. Alrighty, so we've got our roundabout. So we should be good to let that one rip now. We've destroyed a whole load of cars. And we just need to set this up as a roundabout now. Perfect. And we might do a little bit of decorating in the middle as well. In Australia, we love roundabouts with decorating and flower beds and stuff. So we'll continue this that tradition. Let's flatten out this one. And what shall we put on it? So we'll put some nice vegetation on it. And we'll just slightly rearrange those so they're not growing onto the road. Maybe a nice big Australian tree. Maybe a Norfolk pine. Alrighty, so how is our ore area going? Oh, I thought that was the ore area for a second there, and I was like, what's happened to my game? But no, it's over here. Okay. Alrighty, so we need to do both. We need to produce more resources, and we also need to employ more workers. And we've got enough jobs for workers. And we have enough processing, I'd say. We just need to hire some more people. I'm thinking we probably need a bus to get our residents of Belmont over to Banksia Hills for like school and for shopping and stuff like that, because we don't, if we look at our zoning, we don't have any commercial or any schools in this area. So they're gonna have to go out to Banksia Hills to access those amenities. And this is going to be a sort of a local bus service, so it's going to have plenty of stops every couple of blocks or so. No. Why won't you? Hang on. Why is it not? What? No bus stops are placing. Why is that? What? Okay. What's the go? Are these not connected up or something? They look connected to me. Let's try starting it somewhere else. Starting it at the park, perhaps. Okay. We'll have it finishing at our little education campus as well. And just looping back. That's weird. It's like it won't cross this road in this direction. Okay, I'm not sure why that's happening. Okay, so I'm thinking we'll try just 3 buses on this to start with. And we're going to have to use fairly sort of small-ish buses because this is, you know, these are quite small, narrow streets. So I'm thinking we could do the same as we're using for our local service. Down from High Hills, which I believe is the A300K. Yep, so let's run with that. and hopefully this gets some use, and hopefully we'll allow our houses to develop upgrades so we can get more residents into the area. One thing I am noticing is that we've got a lot of crime in this area. And yeah, I mean, we are almost at our jail capacity. It's weird. It's in like the red slash yellow, but we have seven, you know, we're only at like 65% capacity. So I don't know about that. But let's get a police station down in this area to help sort of cover that that requirement or that need for policing over here. And we've got this little area here that we could definitely pop a small police station down on. And at Garnet Ore area, we've actually produced enough resources to level up. We just need more workers. And I also noticed we have a high demand for residential again. So it's probably time to lay down a new neighbourhood. And I'm thinking this sort of area here, bordered by Belmont, Banksia Hills and Birdsong Street, is probably going to be a good area for us to subdivide and, you know, put together as a new community. And I think we might lay this one down a little bit different to Banksia Hills or Belmont. We might actually lay this one down as more of a sort of a curvy roads thing rather than gridded at all. I think sort of in Australia, I think those sort of communities were quite popular in like the early 90s, I want to say. I don't know, because it was cool or something. But we probably need to convert this road here to an actual paved road. So we're gonna have to acquire some houses. Sorry. And we might just change the configuration of this little section here. We'll pull out this connection here and instead continue this on to Olive Street, and we'll just use move it to slightly curve that a little bit more, and maybe curve this a little bit the other way as well. Okay. Perfect. So this area is going to have lots of curved roads, probably a few roundabouts, and a lot of sort of wide open spaces, probably a few parks, stuff like that. But it's not going to have many access roads, I think. We're probably only going to have like one on each side. Might go with some green as well. Actually, we're going to have a little roundabout. So we'll build that straight off the bat. This will be where all the roads meet. They need to be one way as well. That's better. I shouldn't have pulled out those crossroads actually. So we'll just quickly add those back in. And we might actually join this back up at our whatever street that is. I don't recall. Okay, so we've got our sort of central spine to this area, which is immediately being used as a cut through, but whatever, that's fine. And we might go with a fair few smaller roads here, in fact, some little little one unit roads. No, actually, because we need parking. Yeah, that's fine. I think in a lot of sort of the estates in Australia, there is issues of on-street parking not being fantastic. But they have like rollover gutters so that you can still park on the street, but it's stuff like you can't have two cars passing through at once because it's just too too narrow, I guess. And we'll build these as our sort of main joining streets, but we will, in fact, I'll get rid of that. We don't want it to actually join up because we don't want it to be attractive for people to be using these as a thoroughfare. It's more to just connect the, you know, the last 500 meters from this main road to your house. And we'll just build a few sort of cul-de-sacs off these areas. Alrighty, so that's a little bit of a different neighbourhood. And we'll start by laying down our sort of park areas. So we'll get those like all reserved straight away, straight off the bat, so we don't have to go placing them down, you know, after our residential is laid down. And I think dog parks are fantastic. I love dog parks. Love driving past one and seeing all the dogs, you know, playing together and playing with their owners. And we probably actually want to have a primary school here as well, because we're probably going to be at our capacity once we lay down all our new residential here. And probably we might build a playground, and then we've got some space next to it to put a small primary school as well. And maybe some basketball court. Is that a basketball court? Yeah. Basketball court nearby as well. Oops. Nice. Got a little elementary school here as well. So we'll place that next door to the playground and across the road from the basketball court, so they've got access to that during their, you know, recesses and lunch times, etc. And we're pretty much done with our amenities, I think, at this point. I'll just quickly check. Yeah, so we've got high school is getting towards our capacity, but we're still fine. I don't know how public libraries even work, to be honest, in this game, because no one seems to ever use them. But I might just be placing them wrong. So let's just lay down. Let's lay down the neighbourhood first. Okay, and what are we going to call it? Let's call it Birdsong for the road that it sits on. And I'm just going to quickly whip up a nice custom theme here. So please hold. And what we're going to do here is just paint everything. And I'm going to have to go through and unpaint some stuff, I do know that. Like the roundabout, we just put zoning in the middle of. And we probably don't want any on our sort of border roads either, actually. So I'll just quickly remove those. Actually, the border roads between our housing estates, that's probably fine, actually. I'll leave them on there, but not certainly not around a roundabout. And for here, we might actually reserve a little bit of space for some more commercial as well to support our new housing estate. Okay, so let's get playing again. Oh no, we've got a little bushfire happening. Ugh. Got some shops burning down. That's no good at all. Do we have fire helicopters available? We do. So that may be a consideration, especially considering we've got this big nature reserve here, and we've got lots of trees, and we've got lots of like campfires and stuff as well. So I'm thinking now is as good as time as any to start really going for some fire protection. We can't build fire watchtowers yet. but we're almost there. Almost there. Only need 100 more residents, and then we can get some fire watchtowers down to even further protect our environment and our residents. Oh, excellent. We've leveled up. So, what do we have available now? So, we've got campus areas, so we can get a university down. We can work with taxation policies. We've unlocked metro, intercity buses, and a whole lot more new policies, and we get high density zoning as well. We've also get incineration plants, fire watch towers, and a lot of sort of disaster related stuff is unlocked as well. So that's all looking very good. I find it a bit weird that you unlock metro before you unlock railway, to be honest. But I suppose that's an Aussie, you know, just Aussie things. We don't really have metros here. The New South Wales government's recently built one in Sydney, but aside from that, there's nothing really else that you could really consider a metro. And what I'm just going to do here as well is to unzone from the roundabout, because I forgot to do that. So apologies to all the people whose houses are being knocked down, but it just doesn't make sense for you to build there. So sorry, but it's on you. What I want to do, however, is just increase our walking sort of amenities with some targeted sort of path connections. And we can also utilize some of our sort of unzoned areas as well to form those connections. Is good. Just squeeze that in there. Yes, just. Apologies. Okay, so we've got some path connections there that'll hopefully get people walking a little bit more in the neighbourhood. And we can already see, in fact, that people are using those paths. So that is excellent news. Our ore area is looking pretty good. We need 23 more employees to level up to level 2, which I'm excited for. But it just seems like we can't just quite get enough workers at the moment. We are, you know, we've pretty much filled up this new suburb here of Birdsong. We've got a few lots free, but it's not too much. So just people appear to not be wanting to work at our ore area. And perhaps part of the problem is we need some transport to get our employees over there. So what we might do is put on a shuttle bus service to, this probably would be funded by the company that runs the Garnet ore area. And just to allow their employees to hop on and get over to work without having to drive, which is fantastic. Carpooling is fantastic. And probably what we'll do is we'll take it a different route than any of our existing public transport as well. Of course, our citizens can use this as well. That's fine, just like for commuting. But it's not really going to be particularly useful for much else except getting to the ore area. And we'll just have it come down and stop at our ore processors here. and then just straight back. And it appears I've not learnt because I'm once again using a roundabout to turn the bus around. All right, so what are we going to run on this one? I think we might run a very sort of small, just trying to blow everything up. I think we're going to run a very, very small number of vehicles, maybe not that small, but perhaps just a couple. And in terms of our types of vehicles, what could we run with? I've got the A300K, which is one of our small buses, but I think we might go with something a little bit different. We'll introduce a slightly different bus and maybe even a different livery as well. So with the ride pack, they've got, they're constantly releasing new liveries. They've recently put out a series of like Japanese inspired like buses and sort of metro slash trains, and then we've got their original, which is the Azure, which is a sort of a plainish blue or azure, obviously colored livery, and I think we might use that for our little shuttle. So we'll use a K270. And we'll see how we go there. So we've got five, probably not five, maybe four. Can we get it down to four? Four, okay. Okay, and with that shuttle service established for our ore area, that is going to be it for this episode. So we've expanded our residential areas a little bit more. We've expanded and completed Belmont and also built a new slightly more unusual area in Birdsong, but that will be it for this episode. So probably next week is all going to be about getting that ore area leveled up as high as we can, and hopefully, fingers crossed, reaching 9,000 so we unlock railways so we can start doing some cool railway builds. If you've enjoyed this video, please make sure you give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and ring that notification bell so you get a ding to your device the next time I post a video. It was really cool this week to see that we've passed 50 subscribers. That's amazing. Honestly, I didn't think I'd even get 50 subscribers. I thought I'd probably peter out at 10 or 15 once, the friends that I convinced to subscribe had all been subscribed and there was no one else to bother about it. But it's really cool to see people enjoying the content. We'll have a cool, exciting announcement next week around probably what's next for the channel and what's next for me. So I hope you join us on Friday for that one. But until next time, I'm Bob Dendry. This is City Skylines, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.